Today's restorative yoga session will support the stage two task of starting to experiment with manifesting. The full details of how to do this enjoyable task, of which we are trusted with on this earth, are in the roadmap and in the book. But here, we're going to actually use it. As we enjoy our restorative yoga poses, we will be choosing something that you want to make real in your life. Now, manifesting is not magic. It will require some effort, but it begins by identifying something that you want in great detail, feeling it, what it's really like to have it. And then, most importantly, letting it go. We will be iterating this process three times during today's restorative yoga session. So it might be worthwhile to think right now about some of the things that you want to come true in your life. Thank you for joining me today. I'm Kathryn Colleen, and for today's restorative session, we're going to be holding a small set of poses for 15 to 20 minutes each while we carry out a contemplative meditation to support this task of your journey. The poses that I'll show you here today are just suggestions. If at any time you feel that you need or would just like something different, listen to your body and choose whatever pose may support you in this task today. This is Maxwell, and he may be joining us for some of our poses today. You can see I've got a lot of different props around me because this is a restorative session. I have blocks. I'm sitting on a block right now. I have pillows of different sizes. You might have a bolster. I have a sandbag. I have straps of different kinds. We'll see what comes in handy to support ourselves today. We'll begin by setting up the breath. Find a seat comfortably. You might sit on a block. You might sit on a sandbag or a pillow or on nothing at all, or even on a chair. Hands in the lap or on the knees. And we'll just breathe. Let's take a breath and we'll let it out, making the sound of the ocean. Let's breathe in for a count of four. Breathe in one, two, three, four, and out. One, two, three, four. Let's do that again. In, one, two, three, four, and out. One, two, three, four. Let's see if we can breathe in for five. And out for five. Nice. Now let's take a big deep breath in and let it out like a sigh of relief. We'll take another deep breath in and this time let it out slowly, purposefully, all the way.
Be at peace. You are here now. Let's begin today's session. Coming into child's pose, the knees are wide, the toes are touching in the back, and we fold ourselves forward, hands to the mat, extending the arms out, forehead to the mat. Support yourself any way you like. You might like a block or a sandbag under the chest. You might like blocks under the hands. Or a combination of things. The concept is to be completely supported so that you can completely relax into the child's pose. Over the course of our time in this pose, you might add props or remove props. Whatever is most comfortable for you as you take the contemplation. Find your ideal point in this pose.
As we hold our child's pose today, let's think about the first thing that you would like to come true in your life. This might be a thing that you want, a situation you would like to experience, a way that you would like to feel about yourself, a skill you would like to have, anything at all. Think of it now. As we hold this position, imagine it. Imagine that you already have it and that you've had it for a while. How does it feel to have this thing as an everyday part of your life? Or to feel this way about yourself every day? Or to think back on that experience that you had? That you wanted. How does it feel? Satisfying, yes. And probably something more. Take a moment to think about how it feels to have that as an everyday part of your life, that experience, that thing, that feeling. About yourself, that skill, whatever it is. How does it feel to have it? And then once you've felt that, let go of the desire for it. This is definitely the hardest part. To let it go, we mean to no longer care if it comes or not. To let it be. To say, if it comes, that's great. And if it doesn't, that's okay too. But I'm going to do what I can to help make this happen. And if it happens, that's great. And if not, okay. Give it a try. Think of what you want. Feel it. And then put it in the hands of the universe.
Coming now into a supine or reclined bound angle, you have a couple of choices here. You can take this position on the back if you like, lying down, feet together, knees out wide. You might like some blocks under the knees to support you. You can also take a bolster or a pillow under the back. Or you might consider taking this position reclined. To do that, take your first block on its tallest setting. Take your second block on its next lowest setting. Grab a pillow and make yourself an incline. Adjust it as needed. And give it a try. Sit right up against it. Lower yourself down. And that top block should end up supporting the head and the neck very nicely there. Then put the feet in bound angle. Now, being that your blocks are supporting you, in this configuration, they're not under the knees. So you may choose to use extra pillows or sandbags, or you can even scoot the feet out further to make it more comfortable. And remember that you can change things up in the middle of the pose to keep it the most comfortable and the most restorative for you.
As we hold our reclined bound angle, think of the second thing that you wanted. A skill, an object, a feeling, a situation, or an experience. And we will repeat again this process. Think of it. Feel what it would be like to have achieved that or have that. Feel what it would be like to have had it for a while. It's a regular part of your life. And then put it in the hands of the universe or the divine or God. However you would like to view it, let go of the desire for it, knowing that if it serves you, then of course it will be. And if it is not to be, it's because it was not your path.
Coming now into a wide leg forward bend. Take the legs as wide as is comfortable. Again, you may choose to sit on a sandbag for this one. Have your props, your pillows, and your blocks handy. And make yourself comfortable for a forward bend. We're going to be reaching out with the heart so it can help to stack up your pillows and your props. Get creative, have fun with it. And lean, reaching the heart out forward. You can also use a strap in this case. Now this will produce some extra stretch, which you may enjoy or you may not, for a restorative session. So you can use your strap, you can use a TheraBand, but let's take a moment here to get really comfortable in this particular pose.
As we hold our wide leg forward bend as comfortably as we can, think of the third thing that you wanted to bring into your life. A thing, an experience, a feeling, a situation. And we'll repeat this process again. Think of it. Feel what it would be like to have had it for a while. It's a regular part of your life. And then let go of the desire for it by recognizing that if it is to be, it's because it supports you in your mission here on this earth. And if it is not to be, then that is in your best interest too.
Coming down now into Shavasana. Laying flat on the mat, arms at the sides, on the belly, or maybe one hand to the heart and one to the belly. You might like a pillow under the knees. Or a bolster. You might also like a pillow under the head or under the neck. At any time, adjust your props, add them or remove them, whatever is most comfortable. Shavasana is our opportunity to integrate today's practice. Whatever has come up for us, whatever insight we may have gained, or just to relax and to listen to the breath, being in the moment. When you're ready, open your eyes and return to presence. Wiggle the fingers and the toes. Maybe roll the ankles and the wrists. If you're using props, you might remove them now. You might take the arms up overhead for a nice long stretch. You might roll over just to one side to rest for a minute. When you're ready, extend the top leg long, push yourself up back to a seated position. Thank you for joining me today. And thank you for taking the time for yourself. May it be ever fruitful for you. The love and the light and the teacher in me honors that in you. Namaste.